Hi students, good morning everyone. Today I am going to explain you about the nitrosyl, a diatomic molecule, NO, its ligational characters and its molecular orbital diagram and its bonding modes. Right, in this session of the class we are going to cover the all about the nitrosyl as ligand. Right. So let us start the how does the nitrosyl acts as a ligand. Nitrosyl as it is having a pair of electrons in sigma molecular orbital, and it also consists of an empty pi star orbital, right? As it molecule nitrosyl will consist, right, a pair of electrons in a molecular orbital, right, and it also has an empty molecular orbital which having a near equal energies with transitional metal ions orbitals, right? They consist the near equal energies with the transitional metal orbitals. So what happens that by donating a pair of electrons from nitrosyl to metal, it acts as a sigma donor. The nitrosyl will consist a sigma orbital which having an lone pair of electrons, non-bonding electron pairs, thus sigma molecular orbital it donates a pair of electron, so it called as a sigma donor, and it acts as a ligand. By doing this, it acts as a ligand, and it also consists, the nitrosyl will also consist an empty orbital. With that effect of empty orbital having near equal energies with the metal filled orbitals, the nitrosyl can also accept the electron density, and that's how it called as pi acceptor. So far the nitrosyl can be termed as a sigma donor and pi acceptor. Sigma donor and pi acceptor. And it also can be called as pi acidic ligand, right? By donating a pair of electron, its term can be given as ligand. By accepting the electron density from the metal in back, it can be termed as a acid. So it can be classified as a ligand of pi acidic ligand, right? And this nitrosyl having three characters, right? It can also act as a neutral ligand, it can also act as a positive ligand, it can also act as a negative ligand. In all three states of the molecule, positive, negative and neutral, in all these three states it can act as a ligand, right? This having 15 electron density and in valency it consists of 2 electrons in sigma orbital, 1 electron in pi star orbital. It acts as a 3 electron donor, right? How can we prove this is having a carbonyl complex, considered as one carbonyl complex reacting with nitrosyl ligand sites, right? I have here considered that pentacarbonyl iron complex with reacting with nitrosyl molecules, where three of the carbonyls were replaced by two of the nitrosyl. Three of the carbonyls in this reaction replaced by two of the nitrosyl, right? Here each carbonyl, we know that it is a two electron donor, right? And thus two electron donor, right, of three moieties, three two electron donors replaced by two of nitrosyl, nothing but six electrons are replaced by two of nitrosyl. So then the each nitrosyl become a three electron donor, which can justifies or evidences that the nitrosyl can act as a three electron donor, right? So like this, the nitrosyl can be acts as a three electron donor in linear mode, linear bonding mode. It can act as a three electron donor. When it is donating single electron, it would be have the bonding mode of bent mode. Bent bonding mode, in bent bonding mode, it can act as a single electron donor, right? So like this, what is the bent mode, what is the linear mode? In the next topic, we will going to see in the bonding modes of the nitrosyl. But here you say that the nitrosyl can act as a three electron donor in linear bonding mode. The nitrosyl can also can act as a single electron donor in bent bonding mode, right? And this could be having a near equal qualities or characters of the carbonyl. The nitrosyl positive ion, right, positive ion having near here having an equal electrons of carbonyl, right? Nitrosyl in neutral consists of 15 electron. When it is in positively charged, mono positively charged, it will have 14 electron. This moiety has similar electrons of equal number of 14 electrons of carbonyl. So as it is having an 14 electron, right, and near equal 14 electrons of carbonyl, it behaves, right, similar behaviors, right, ligational behaviors of carbonyl can be existed by the nitrosyl, right, such as it also consists of synergic mechanism. This is known to you, right? It is already expressed in carbonyl ligational character. In defining the carbonyl ligational character, I have expressed what is the synergic mechanism. What is the synergic mechanism? Is simple. When it is here, if we expressing the synergic mechanism in nitrosyl, right, nitrosyl is a sigma donor. So when it is donate a pair of electron from nitrosyl nitrogen side to metal, it become an electron deficient, isn't it? Once it is donate a pair of electron, what it become, right, it loses the electron density from nitrogen side, right? So it will become electron deficient, right, after donation of electron pair to the metal atom. Then in terms of when it is deficient, what happens? It is eager to gain the electron, right, where it is having an empty orbital in it, and it is deficient in this situation of donation, after donation. So it is very eager, very character, very effectively can accept the electron density from the metal side. So that what it behaves, that it will accept the electron from the metal side in faster mode, in effectively it will grab the electron density from the metal side, as it is electron deficient after the donation, right? So it will become strong acceptor, pi acceptor, right? So after getting pi accepting, right, electron density from the metal side to nitrosyl, once it is accept the electrons, there it will again become electron rich, right? Once it is accepting the electron, what it becomes? It will become electron rich. And when once it is reaches to the electron rich character, again the sigma donation will be effectively done by the nitrosyl, and it will strengthens the sigma donation capacity, right? It is synergetic mechanism is nothing but what? The what we can say that strengthening of sigma character, sigma donor character, and strengthening by donor character, strengthening the accepting character, and once it is accepting character reaches, and it is strengthens the donor character, right? That auto charging the electron density on nitrosyl will be known as synergetic mechanism. That also this synergetic mechanism actually exhibit initially in the carbonyl, expressed in an carbonyl having near equal energies with the carbonyl, nitrosyl also will exist, thus synergetic mechanism, right? So this is how about the nitrosyl as the ligand. Nitrosyl will have the pair of electrons in sigma molecular orbital and has empty orbital in it. These sigma electrons and pi empty orbitals has near equal energies with the transitional metal atom metal ion orbitals, and so far the donor acceptor from nitrosyl to metal can be easily done, and when it is donate a pair of electron, it will be called as sigma donor. Once it is accept the electrons from the metal side, right, that would be called as acceptor, pi acceptor. So having donation and accepting character, this is termed as a pi acidic ligand, and the nitrosyl can act in all three states of the atom, that is molecular state, neutral, positive, negative. In all these three statements, it can all act as a ligand site, and it is an 3-electron donor. Thus can be proven by the having reactions with the metal carbonyls with nitrosyl ligand, it will be replaces each three carbonyls by the 2 nitrosyl, where single carbonyl donate a 2 electron. So 3 carbonyls nothing but it equivalent of 6 electrons, and thus 6 equivalent carbonyls replaced by the 2 nitrosyl nothing but the 2 nitrosyl will satisfy the 6 electron density. So from 2 satisfying the 6 electron, 2 nitrosyl satisfying the 6 electron nothing but each nitrosyl will satisfy the 3 electron density. Like that we will prove that the nitrosyl will act as a 3 electron donor, and it acts as a 3 electron donor in linear mode of bonding, and it also acts as a single electron donor in bent bonding mode, right? And this has a similar electron density with the carbonyl. So far it also exhibit the synergetic mechanism, where the donor character of nitrosyl is strengthened by the acceptor nature, and acceptor nature is strengthened by the donor character, right? That's all about the nitrosyl as a ligand, right? Now let us move on for the molecular orbital energy level diagram of nitrosyl. To draw the molecular orbital energy level diagram, initially we will draw the atomic orbitals of nitrogen site and oxygen site. Before that, we will have an energy scale from down to top. It enhances the energy. That's how it shows. So let us show the nitrosyl atomic orbitals. Right. 1s, 2s, 2p. And next by will we have oxygen atomic orbitals. These oxygen atomic orbitals are slightly lesser energetic than the nitrogen atomic orbital. Why? Because from the nitrogen to oxygen, oxygen is more electronegative. Once it is more electronegative from the other side, the atomic orbitals will be slightly less energetic than the first one, right? So this is nitrogen atomic orbitals 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. This is atomic oxygen atomic orbital 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Right. So that's how the atomic orbitals. Here, before going for the Markle orbitals, there will be hybridized orbital we will share. There will be the nitrosyl will have sp hybridization. So that you will draw here. In sp hybridization, one of 2s orbital of nitrogen, one of 2p orbital of nitrogen will club together, will generate an moderate energetical, two equal energetical orbitals, that is 2sp orbitals, and left two 2p orbitals energies will be the same energy, 2p orbitals, right. These sp orbitals will be go for the sigma bonding nature. These two non-hybridized orbitals of 2p will counts for the pi bonding, isn't it? The Markle orbital can be, the nitrosyl Markle orbital can be generated by linear combination of atomic orbitals of nitrogen and oxygen, where the atomic orbitals of nitrogen oxygen linear combination 1s1s of the nitrogen and oxygen will generate the two Markle orbitals of nitrosyl 1 sigma and 2 sigma, and to have them Markle orbitals, atomic orbitals of the nitrogen and oxygen, before that we will have the hybridized orbitals from the nitrogen side as well as from the oxygen side, where the linear combination of 2s and 2p of the nitrogen side will generate the 2r sp hybridized orbital and two non-hybridized orbitals 2p. Similarly, on oxygen side also, sp, two of sp, one of sp and one of 2p and one of 2s will combines to generate the 2sp hybridized orbital, and left 2p orbitals will be have in remain in the same state of non-hybridized orbital state, right? These hybridized and non-hybridized sites of the nitrogen and oxygen will have the linear combination to have the next level of Markle orbitals of nitrosyl molecule. In that, the 2sp orbitals of oxygen side will generate one non-bonding Markle orbital side, and from similar to that, the nitrogen side of 2sp also will have one non-bonding Markle orbital, and left one of 2sp and one of 2sp of the oxygen and nitrogen each will generate one of bonding and another of anti-bonding Markle orbital for the nitrosyl, and that's how the 3 sigma, 4 sigma, 5 sigma and 6 sigma sites will be generated for the nitrosyl, right, in linear combination of two sp orbitals of each nitrogen and oxygen, right? And next left two p orbitals of nitrogen and two p orbitals of oxygen. Non-hybridized orbitals of oxygen and nitrogen will linearly combines to have the pi bonding molecular orbitals, that is one pi bonding orbitals and one pi star antibonding orbital sites. Like this, the all the molecular orbitals will be generated for the nitrosyl in combination of nitrogen and oxygen linear orbital combination, right? And left in electron filling, nitrogen has the 7 electron density 1s2 2s2 2p3 and oxygen having an 8 electron density 1s2 2s2 2p4 and altogether it has an 15 electrons, and thus 15 electrons once if you fill in the nitrosyl, right, it will generate the 1 sigma 2 2 sigma 2 3 sigma 2 4 sigma 2 1 pi 4 having two orbitals in 1 pi, it will be have capacity of 4 electron density, like that 1 pi 4, and next pi 5 sigma will be have 2 electrons and 1 pi star will have 1 electron. Like this, the electron configuration of nitrosyl will be this, right? And in all this getting the molecular orbital, we have to be significantly notify the HOMO and LUMO in molecular orbital diagram, where HOMO is nothing but high energetical occupied in terms of electron. Molecular orbital will be known as HOMO, and LUMO is nothing but low energetical unoccupied in terms of electrons, and molecular orbital jumbo is nothing but molecular orbital, right? That's how two things we have to notify in the molecular orbitals of nitrosyl, where in down to top the energy is in increasing, the energy is increasing, so which nothing but 1 sigma will be the lowest energetical orbital, 6 sigma is the highest energetical orbital, right? So from 1 sigma to 6 sigma energy is increasing, and filled orbital also once if we recognize 1 sigma to 1 sigma star, 1 pi star is the orbitals are filled, but 1 pi star we cannot consider as a fully filled orbital site. Having only one electron, it cannot be considered as a fully filled, right? So filled orbital site we can consider till 5 sigma. Fully filled site is 5 sigma, right? So 1 sigma to 5 sigma it is enhancing the energy, and the 5 sigma is the highest energetical occupied, fully occupied molecular orbital. So far 5 sigma we have term as a HOMO, we can notify as a HOMO, right? LUMO, when it come low energetical it require, right? Low energetical is 1 sigma, here it is, but it should to be unoccupied, right? To get the LUMO it should to be unoccupied, right? So 1 sigma is a occupied orbital, fully occupied orbital, so we cannot consider till the 5 sigma, they are all occupied orbitals, but where the unoccupied orbitals are 1 pi star and 6 sigma, right? 1 pi star also we can consider as a unoccupied, having only one electron cannot be considered as a occupied orbital, right? So this is the two orbital sites, molecular orbital sites, which having an unoccupied, right, which are not having any electron density, right, having not any electron density, right? So that the in these two, right, considering the energy, the 1 pi star is the lowest energetical than the 6 sigma, so the 1 pi star could be a low energetical unoccupied molecular orbital, that is LUMO, right? So like that, the HOMO is 5 sigma, LUMO is 1 pi star, right? So getting HOMO LUMO in nitrosyl, the HOMO LUMO are having a near equal energies with the molecular orbitals, transitional metal molecular orbital. There these HOMO LUMO will have the bonding with the metal ion, and 5 sigma having electron density, right, non-bonding electron pair, it donates electron, nitrosyl will donate electrons from the 5 sigma, and it will behaves as a sigma donor, and having an empty orbital in LUMO, right, in site of LUMO, right, 1 pi star, it accepts the electron density from the metal side and it behaves as a sigma donor, sorry, pi acceptor, right? Like that, the donor and acceptor natures will be presented for the nitrosyl like this, right? Where to have the bonding site in the nitrosyl, is the bonding site oxygen or nitrogen? To finish that, right, we have to know that homo-lumo characters, right? Which character, right? Nitrogen character or oxygen character is carried by the homo-lumo, we have to find out, right? To find out that, the energies of the homo-lumo and the energies from which the homo-lumo is generating, we have to consider the homo-lumo near equal energies of the oxygen, the atomic sites from which the homo-lumo are generated, this will be character that follows, right? Considering the homo, coming to the homo, right? Homo is an generated from the two sp orbitals of nitrogen site. It is a non-bonding molecular orbital and that is generated from the nitrogen sp orbital. So this homo will carry the nitrogen character, nitrogen atomic character, right? And coming to lumo, lumo is also having near equal energies with the 2p orbitals of the nitrogen site, right? Lumo having near equal energies of 2p orbitals of nitrogen site. It is having large energy gap between of lumo to 2p orbitals of oxygen. So these lumo, again, they have the characters of 2p of nitrogen. So far, this lumo can also be considered as a nitrogen site. So the nitrogen, the homo lumo will have the nitrogen character. Nitrogen character, right? So having nitrogen characters of homo lumo, nothing but the donor site and acceptor site, molecular sites, orbital sites of donor and acceptor sites are having nitrogen characters. The bonding should to be from metal to nitrogen, from but not the nitrogen to oxygen. This is completely wrong. This is correct, right? Why it is correct? Now we got that, right? And having electron density in 5 sigma 2 electrons, 1 pi star 1 electron, the nitrosyl acts as a 3 electron donor, right? In valency, the higher energy orbitals, right, near equal energy orbitals with the metal orbital site near equal energies of homo lumo, right, where thus homo lumo will consist the 3 electron density. So this all will be can be shifted from nitrosyl side to metal side, so it will become 3 electron donor, right? It can behave as a 3 electron donor, and it can also acts as a single electron donor by having donation from only the 1 pi star orbital, right? It can donate all the 3 electrons from the 5 sigma and 1 pi star and behaves as a sigma 3 electron donor, and it also can donate only 1 electron density of 1 pi star, behaves as a single electron donor. So the nitrosyl will can be, sometime it will be 3 electron donor, in some time it will be 1 electron donor. In the linear bonding mode it will be 3 electron donor, in the bent bonding mode it will be single electron donor. This depends the donor capacity of the nitrosyl, capacity of the nitrosyl will depends upon the requirement on metal ion, right? If the metal ion is having sufficient number of empty orbitals to occupy the 3 electrons from the nitrosyl side, the nitrosyl will be behaves as a linear bonding mode 3 electron donor. If the metal site having only single electron capacity, single electron accepting capacity, there the nitrosyl will become single electron donor in bent bonding mode, right? Like that, the nitrosyl, its molecular orbital diagram, its ligational characters can be defined here, right? So next we have to move on for the bonding modes of the nitrosamine, right? Here we are discussing the bonding modes bent and linear, na? Like that there are different types of bonding modes nitrosamine will project, right? Present, that we will discuss here. Nitrosyl ligand bonding modes. Right. Bonding mode is can be referred as a molecule, a ligand, right? Behaves within single metal and multiple metals, right? Its behavior with respect of single metal and multiple metal is known as bonding mode, right? How it is forming the bonds with the single metal or multiple metals of a ligand, right, will be considered as a bonding mode, right? So here the nitrosyl can bind with single metal and can also bind with multiple metal, nothing but two or three metals. It can also at a single molecule, single nitrosyl molecule can bind with two or three metal sites, right? So it is having in single metal bonding, right? When it is forming in single metal, bond with a single metal, it has two different types in it, right? Those are called as terminal, or this all can be called as terminal bonding mode. Terminal bonding mode, when nitrosyl forming bond with a single metal, it would be termed as a terminal bonding way. And in this terminal bonding mode, it has two types: terminal lineal, terminal bent. Bent terminal, linear terminal, right? Bent terminal, linear terminal. Let us see how the bent terminal and how it is linear terminal can be has the nitrosyl site. When a metal site having bond with nitrogen of nitrosyl in a linear, where the bond angle from the MNO is 180 degrees, thus bonding mode called as linear terminal bonding mode. Right, when there is a metal, nitrogen and oxygen, when there is a nitrosyl bonding with single metal and its bond angle is less than 180, that could be called as bent terminal bonding mode. Bent terminal bonding mode, right? When it is having 180 degrees of angle from MNO angle of MNO, if it is 180, it is linear in bonding, right? Having linear shape in bond, it would be said as linear bonding. When it is having an angular shape, right, angularly the nitrosyl bonds with the metal ion and its angle of MNO is less than 180, it would be called as bent bonding mode, right? Looking to the example molecule, right, cobalt multi, bisdias nitrosyl cobalt molecule is having a bonding mode of linear and it has the bond angle from molybdenum cobalt nitrogen oxygen is 180 degrees linear bonding mode, where same cobalt site and having excess of thiocyanide dias bis dias bisdias thiocyanide nitrosyl cobalt complex will have the cobalt nitrogen oxygen site in bonding mode, bent bonding mode, right? This is what happened, right? The bent site and linear site of nitrogen will suggest the 3 electron donor and 1 electron donor of the nitrosyl. In linear bonding mode, it donate 3 electrons to the metal. In bent bonding mode, it donate only 1 electron. Right. So, it is simple that when there is a metal site, we know that why the nitrosyl acts as a 3 electron donor, single electron donor. Just now I told you in molecular orbital energy level diagram. When metal side has requirement of 3 electrons, the nitrosyl will donate 3 electrons to the metal and it behaves in a linear bonding mode. It has the bonding of linear bonding mode. When metal having only requirement of single electron, the nitrosyl is thus flexible as it is donating single electron and it will forms in bent bonding mode, right? Same as the situation here it arises, right? So in these two moieties, the cobalt site in here, right, in this complex of metal, the cobalt will have the empty space to occupy the 3 electrons. It is 3 electron deficient to have the electrons in valency of 18, right? To have 18 electron density on this particular metal complex, the metal requires the 3 electrons. So far, the nitrosyl binding with the cobalt will donate 3 electrons and in linearly donate the 3 electrons will forms linear bonding mode, right? Behaves as a 3 electron donor and forms a linear bonding mode, where this particular complex, when it is bonded with thiocyanide, attacked with a thiocyanide, the thiocyanide will donate a pair of electron, where after donation of electron pair from the thiocyanide, the cobalt is very deficient. It deficiency will decreases from the 3 electrons to single electron. In thus single electron deficiency, the nitrosyl will donate only 1 electron, where in 1 electron donor, the nitrosyl will have the bonding mode of bent, right? It cannot be linearly approached towards the cobalt site. It will be sidewise. In a bent mode, it will approaches towards the cobalt and by donating single electron. Like this, it happens in the nitrosyl complexes, right? So, the nitrosyl may be linear in bonding mode by donating 3 electrons. It may bent terminal mode with single metal by donating single electron, right? So this is what about the bonding modes of the nitrosyl when it is binding with only one metal. When it is having multiple metals, right? So with the two metals, it can act as a doubly bridged ligand, right? The nitrosyl can act as a doubly bridging ligand, and the nitrosyl can also act as a triply bridging ligand site. Nothing but at a single nitrosyl can bind with two metal side, and the single nitrosyl can also bind with three metal side. Right, single nitrosyl can bind three metal side, can bind two metal side. Right, for example, tris cyclopentadiene tetranitrosyl manganese complex. When we consider here in this, all four nitrosyls may not be having same bonding mode, they has different bonding mode. Three manganese. These three manganese sites are doubly bridged by three nitrosyls, and these three manganese binded with each one of cyclopentadiene, and third nitrosyl will binds all three manganese sites. Right, so here centrally situated, this will act as a triply bridging nitrosyl, and the sidewise sites will be doubly bridging. Doubly bridging nitrosyl sites. So like this, the nitrosyl can act as a doubly bridging and triply bridging, right? So this is how the bonding modes of the nitrosyl we can express, right? It has the terminal bonding mode, it also has the bridging bonding mode. In terminal, it has two types of terminal, linear and bent. With requirement of metal site, electron density requirement, it can act as a linear, it can act as a bent. When there is a metal having a deficiency of 3 electron, by donating 3 electrons, nitrosyl will be have linear bonding mode, where the angle of MNO will be equal to 180 degrees, where when there is a metal requirement deficiency, electron deficiency is only one, in this case nitrosyl donate only one electron, it forms an bent bonding mode, and there the angle of MNO will be less than 180. That can be easily compared in the cobalt complex, right? Where in the first cobalt complex, it has the requirement of 3 electrons. There the nitrosyl donate 3 electrons, and it behaves as a 3 electron donor and linear in bonding mode. The angle of cobalt NO will be 180, where once this complex coordinated with the thiocyanate, extra coordination with the thiocyanate donating a pair of electron, the cobalt deficiency will be decreases from the 3 to 1, where one electron deficient cobalt will accept only one electron from the nitrogen side of nitrosyl. So where the nitrosyl donate one electron and it will have a bent bonding mode, the angle of cobalt nitrogen oxygen will be less than 180. That's how the linear and bent bonding modes, and bridging bonding modes of nitrosyl will have doubly bridging and triply bridging, where in doubly bridging two metals will be coordinated with nitrosyl, in triply bridging the nitrosyl will coordinate three metal side. For example, when we check into a manganese complex, tris cyclopentadiene and tetranitrosyl complex, where the tetranitrosyl in which 3 will be triply bridging, 1 will be, sorry, 2, 3 will be doubly bridging, 1 will be triply bridging, like this is the structure, right? And having a triply doubly bridgings of the nitrosyl ligand side, right? Here I conclude the class. By the next we will be go with new topic of nitrosyl. Thank you.